What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm introducing you to our latest family member. This is Poppy. She's an English Bulldog. If you don't already follow me on Instagram or have seen my previous video, we already have an English Bulldog. His name is Chopper, so this is his new sister. So if you want to see this video about Poppy, then keep on watching. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel.
Got to the airport and we are coming to pick up our little puppy dog. We're just waiting outside. Her plane has landed, so we're just sitting here having a cool drink of water. Hey bud. And we're at the little cargo area. Who's that, Chopper? Is that Poppy? Poppy? Hi, baby. Is that your sister? Yeah, that's your sister.
Okay, so first things first is we have had Chopper. He's about a year and a half old, and we got him from this amazing breeder in our country and had him brought down to us, and we've just enjoyed him so much. If you're not familiar with English Bulldogs, they are quite emotional animals, so he has been a little bit lonely. He does go to play school and socializes really well with other dogs and things like that, but we knew we'd always wanted another dog as well, and the timing seemed right. We'd been looking at getting Poppy, or like a female English Bulldog, for about 4 months now, and there was always something that had happened, or like the way that the nose was shaped looked like that we were going to be getting a lot of that breathing problems with the dog, things like that. So we passed on one, and then the breeder had a pregnancy again, and then the dog was bitten by a snake, so the lost the litter. So then Poppy came along, and this latest litter, and I'm actually filming this during this lockdown. So we got Poppy the day before we went into a 21-day lockdown, which is actually pretty perfect because we've both been home, being able to potty train her and train her, and being able to socialize with Chopper and things like that. But she's chewing on my hair. But I'm gonna give you guys, see if I can sit back and let you just see this fat thing. But yeah, so Poppy is 9 weeks old, I think today. So she's actually from, like I said, the same breeder. And what's really cool is Poppy and Chopper, Pop and Chop, they share the same dad. So they're half siblings, which is really cool. She's got a lot of different markings than Chopper, but, and they have, okay, I let you down. They have completely different personalities. Chopper loves to be near you, but he doesn't love affection, where this one, she's literally right here. I just put her down, but now she wants to come back. She loves the affection and attention. Also, Chopper's not vocal. She's very vocal. She'll cry and bark and let you know when she needs to go out, where Chopper will just sit by the door and he's quiet. Even when he doesn't feel good, he never moans. He'll bark at like the occasional car going by and things like that, but on the overall, we've really enjoyed having a second dog in the house. We ummed and awed about it for a long time. We were worried that it was going to create, like, make our house seem smaller, that we would have this pressure that we would need to move homes because of the two dogs. But Bulldogs aren't, Chopper's really active, but they don't need as much activity as a Lab would or a Golden Retriever would. So they're great apartment dogs, so we've been just fine in the house. She is obsessed with Chopper. Chopper is still, he's still, you know, trying to figure it out. He definitely was, his little world was rocked when we got Poppy, because he's obviously been the only dog in our house, and he's definitely finding it a hard time to, or finding a hard time sharing his toys with her and things like that. But they're finding their groove, and they do love to play around mealtime and things like that. And she just follows him around, and she does basically anything that he's doing, she'll do. So that's great with the potty training and stuff, because he'll go on the grass and then she knows, okay, I'm also supposed to go on the grass, things like that. So far, she is, like I said, only 9 weeks, but we're teaching her to sit, and she does know how to sit. We're just introducing distraction now, so, and like trying to teach her farther away, like asking for the command farther away, and you know, maybe with Chopper in the room. It definitely is hard to train with Chopper in the room, because with the treats, he just will like push her out of the way just to get the treat. So I have very limited time to being able to train her. Normally Clive will take Chopper outside to like go to the bathroom, and then I'll use that time. You really only need 10 minutes a day with puppies, because after that it's just like that's as long as they can pay attention for. So 10 minutes a day, and she's learned to sit, but she's just so adorable. I actually have to show you this baby face up close. So she's got these cute little stinky eyes, and she's got a lot of really cute markings. She's got a little sweet paw there with a little black toenail, and she's mostly white, with the exception, I'll just turn her around. Yeah, we're gonna do hugs now. Oh yes, we're gonna do some little hugs. So she's obviously full of wrinkles, and she does have like a little brown body here, but the other half of her is very much white. So just kind of showing you off her markings. She's completely different looking to Chopper, but you can tell like they have the same bone build. So she's got a really nice amount of bone in her snout, which is really good for English Bulldogs because they do have such trouble breathing. So if you can find one immediately when they're young with more bone in the snout, then they are probably going to be easier off in the summertime, not getting as overheated and things like that. But we're just really enjoying her. And her name, Poppy, we've always loved that name. Clive's grandfather was named Chopper. That was his nickname. So we decided to name Chop, obviously, after Chopper. And his grandmother, her nickname was Pop. So we decided to do Pop and Chop, and we thought that was really cute. The two of them, the duo together. It's really kind of fun to also be able to make sure that the names kind of go well together, Pop and Chop. It's easier to call them both off at the same time when you need them. Little Popsy, Popperoni, Pop Pepperoni. But yeah, we're just loving her so much. At the moment, she is 5 kgs. And she eats about 75 grams 3 times a day. And we have her on Royal Canin puppy, bulldog puppy, but we mix it with raw food. So Chopper eats raw food from one of our local stores here called Vondi's Holistic Pet, and they supply pre-made minced food for dogs. It's got herbs and different things in it. It's really good for them. So Chopper will either eat ostrich or mutton. So at the moment we've got a bunch of mutton that we bought pre-lockdown. So within that 75 grams, the 75 grams totals to about like 50 grams of dry dog food since we're transitioning her. And then the other 25 grams is the raw food mixed with a little bit of brown rice. We've just found with Chopper when we raised him that he was eating dry food for a long time, and then he was having like all these problems with his skin, like his hair was falling out. He was constantly sick. We were sending him to the vet all the time. And I swear, as soon as we changed his food, she's crawling behind me now. As soon as we changed his food, all of his ailments went away, and his coat is glossy and thick and shining, and you can tell she immediately wants that food way more than her dry food, and it works out to be the same exact price. So for us, it's a no-brainer. Excuse you. You can't jump off there. You're too tiny. You're too tiny. So it works out to be the same exact price. So we will eventually have her fully transitioned onto raw dog food. And I cannot stress that enough. I was never one of those people. My dogs never grew up like that growing up. But with a bulldog, they are so much more sensitive, like their stomachs and their skin and everything. So if you have a place that does that, that is awesome. But if not, then use what you have. A fed dog is a happy dog, but we just prefer, we're already feeding Chopper that, so it's, you know, not any more out of the way to go and add a little bit to her bowl as well. But she definitely is more into the raw food than her puppy food. But like I said, we have the bag, we're on lockdown here, so that is basically what her diet consists of. And then in terms of potty training her, we've just been trying to take her out like every 20 minutes, and at the end of the night, the big one is like, normally they can't make it through the night without making an accident. We obviously keep the patio door open, but puppies get distracted and they make little accidents and things like that. So before we go to bed, like literally before we, you know, finish reading the book or the TV or whatever, we will take her out one last time to use the bathroom. And that usually helps. Most mornings we've been coming out and there's been like maybe an accident. And then recently, not so much, which is great. So she's definitely catching on. She knows where to use the bathroom. It's just a matter of like taking her there every single time and praising her. Yeah, that's as much as we've got going on so far. She still sleeps a whole lot because she's really little right now. Chopper also, obviously, he likes to nap. It's like cold and rainy today, so they're both feeling like quite tired and sleepy. I'm gonna let her I'm gonna put her down so she can, you know, rest and stuff. But I hope you guys have gotten like a little cool little glimpse into this. I have a video on my channel. This video is just more to introduce you to her. I'll definitely have her in a lot more videos, and I want to do a video of like Chopper and her together, how they're coping, because feeding dogs together at the same time can be difficult, and like how they get along together if you're thinking about getting a second dog. So I'll do a different video on that, but this is just to introduce you to our new little family member, and we're just so excited to have her, and we feel really blessed because right before the lockdown, we had obviously been wanting a bulldog, but before the lockdown, a lot of the people who are wanting these dogs decided that they didn't want them anymore because they didn't want to have to deal with an animal during the lockdown. So not only did we get her for a very good price, but we basically, she was going to be going to a shelter. So it was perfect. Same breeder, same dad. So they're half siblings, which was so cool to us. And they just are learning to find their groove. They definitely love to play together. Chopper's, you know, teaching her about like his little ways of things, but Poppy. But yeah, I just wanted to introduce you guys to Poppy. She is just the most precious thing, and we're just loving her, and love that Chopper now has some company. It's awesome to see them playing together, and if you have any questions for me, please write them down in the comment section below. I will try and link that other video up for you guys as well. Until next time, be kind to one another, stay safe, and we'll see you on the next one. Bye. Say bye!